scene is basically JC is brought into this mysterious motel by his father. And, you know, this guy thinks that this is a place that illegal immigrants come in to get refuge, or, you know, where they do something illegal, where the father gives them, like, fake documents to cross the border in this this Western country with a giant wall. But he soon realizes that this motel has a different purpose, and that it's to actually kill these immigrants in this country. And the way they do it is through this crazy bit. Well, my first film is a very straightforward kind of art house drama with the late Pepe Smith. And it was very, you know, it's a very small film, it's a very intimate film. And we wanted to try something totally different this time for the second film. So with my producer, Bianca, who also co-wrote the film, we decided, like, let's go crazy as we can, as different as we can. So we came up with the idea, let's go with, let's try something supernatural, let's try something with a horror element to it. So the craziest thing we could think about is, what if there was, you know, the legend of, you know, Philippines, we have a lot, not just Philippines, in Southeast Asia, we have a lot of supernatural creatures, and all of them are linked to the forest. We have a very strong connection with our forests. So the idea is that what if there was a tree demon in this forest, and what if these illegal loggers kind of cut down this tree? So what if the spirit of this tree demon is stuck inside the wood, and then what if you cut up this wood as people do to make things, and what if they made into this bit? So this bit now has a vengeful desire to eat the men that cut it down and impregnate the women, so to speak. And then from there, I guess it got into a lot of international script labs. So there's a bit of like an international kind of touch to it. And also the casting with the international actors, I think it all came down to a lot of international co-production with this film. Well, it's all thanks to my producer, Bianca. But the idea of the casting, I think, you know, in our industry locally, like, we just like to work with our friends, right? Mm-hmm. Like actors, people who know you, who are good, but also have a great kind of rapport with. But it's the same with this thing as well, of the international actors, like one of the antagonists, Don, played by Nicholas Saputra. Basically, he's kind of like the John Lloyd of Indonesia. Mm-hmm. But Bianca met him in a festival in Berlin many years ago, and then they kind of kept in touch. Same thing with Bron Pelare, the Malaysian actor. Is kind of like, I met him, being Malaysian myself, kind of we have this camaraderie when we go out internationally, say, like, we should work together. Mm-hmm. And then the same thing with the Thai actor, Viteya, who was in Only God Forgives with Ryan Gosling, mm-hmm. By Nicholas Winding Refn. And also, I think the idea is, like, all these relationships were created through the international circuit. And then it's kind of like, we should really work together. And then it's always a joke when you say that, let's work together, because how would you fit this in, you know, how would these guys come in? But then when there's a project that's international like this, with a subject matter about immigration, about how these kind of immigrants from our part of the world, Southeast Asia, end up in this mystical Western land where they think it's the best place to be, and then suddenly they need to escape from this place. So I think it kind of naturally and organically kind of fell into place.
Just curious, why did it become Motel Acacia? And was that like the perfect tree for you? Because there are various mystical trees in the Philippines.
Yeah.
And the foremost is Balete.
Yeah, but Motel Balete sounds a bit
No, and I think, and it was also the word hotel.
Yeah.
I mean the motel, because it's quite different here in the Philippines.
Yeah.
Why is it?
I mean, as you will see in the film, like the idea of motel or place of inhabiting is really a front. It's just this facade that the father uses to kind of lure the immigrants inside. So people thinking they're going to this refuge of a motel, but when they finally get there, they realize that this is not really the place. And the motel itself, or rather the place of Motel Acacia in the film, is actually underground. It's kind of like an underground, kind of strange, mystical bunker.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, there's a lot of... Immediately from the start, you know that this is not a regular motel. This is not motel at all. This is a place where horrible things happen. So Motel Acacia is more of a front that the father uses in the film. Yeah. I don't think we ever go out to try and, like, promote Asian cinema. We go out to tell stories and do our own cinema.
Mm-hmm.
Especially in Southeast Asia, we are so diverse and so unique, yet so united in our films. Like, you can tell the film is from Southeast Asia because of a certain aesthetic, or maybe we all deal with dreams, we all deal with supernatural things. Even in regular dramas, there's always this mystical element. So, I mean, for us, I think what's important is we just keep telling our own kind of cinema and not try to emulate or copy, even if Korean cinema is Asian cinema, but I think it's totally different from what we do.
Mm-hmm.
And I think there's a lot of merit in what we do as well. Oh, yeah, I'm a big fan of Kubrick's work, but I think this is more of a little bit of a Ridley Scott kind of feeling, a lot of inspiration from the first Alien movie. Maybe also a lot of The Thing by Carpenter, and a little feeling of the Thing as well inside. But it's kind of all just like references of certain small little elements, but...
Mm-hmm.
But in terms of like the claustrophobia, the feeling of like you can't get out from this place, the cold, the horrible cold, I think, yeah, in terms of The Shining, I think that's kind of what we wanted to bring as well. I think it's something we can't escape from. I think we are also very desensitized here in Southeast Asia. We think that it is not something that applies to us because we don't live in a Western country. But we are the ones going to these countries. We are the ones ending up in these places thinking it's the better place. And when we get there, we are treated like second-class citizens. So maybe for me, it's always this idea of like, why do we think that going to the West is the answer to all our problems? Maybe we need to fix things right here. Ah, it's fantastic. I mean, they're like the quintessential Filipino actors, right? It's like you tell them the scene, you put the camera there, action, and then you get it on the first take, and then it's magic. Yeah. But I think it's very interesting as well when if we go back to actor process, because the Belgian actor Jan Bijvoet, I mean, is fantastic. But he also emphasizes a lot on dialogue per se. So he needs to get the dialogue specifically correct in specific intonations. Whereas, like you said, the Filipino actors are more like they just feel it in the moment. But then you have the Indonesian actor who also feels it, but he won't feel it until a little bit into the take. He needs to get into gear. So I think a very challenging moment is when maybe six of them or seven of them all in the same frame. And then you realize that everyone is kicking into gear in different times. So I guess it was really interesting to try and balance it out and try to figure out how to get the best moments from everyone.
Derek, how excited are you now that the movie will have its local run?
This is the best part. I mean, coming back, shooting here and then going out, but then coming back and having the local audience watch it and feel it and maybe scream a little, I think it'll be the best part, because this film really belongs to Southeast Asia, and the spirit and the soul is Southeast Asian, so I'm very excited. I think the way we wanted to come in with the look and the design of the film with the production designers and Benjamin Padero, Carlo Tabihe, who also did Henna Luna, and then also the cinematographer Larry Manda, one of the legends of our industry. When we came in with the design, we really wanted it to be different. We didn't want like a classic kind of creepy, dark hallway kind of feeling, because if this was a front, if this was a facade where people are supposed to feel allegedly safe when they enter the motel, it needed to have a very different kind of feeling. So we kind of went about making it feel like you're underground in the spaceship, kind of like. So it's got a very science fiction kind of vibe going on in this motel. That's why everything is kind of this metallic gleam that's very bright. So I think that's very special, because usually when you watch a quote-unquote scary film or something, it's very dark and, you know, something's going to pop out. But here, I think it's more terrifying when everything is lit, so you see everything in its all, its horrific glory.
And I'd like to say something also, because we shot in a studio for two studios for like 2 weeks, right? And they turned down the temperature. Talagang it was so cold. It was really, really cold. And we were layered with vests and sweaters and outer covering, but we were still cold. That was Bradley, so saying he really wanted us to feel the cold. And even we didn't have to act cold, you know, that we were cold. It was just really cold. And then he submerged me and another woman in the pool that is so cold. Seriously, talagang para akong, ooh. But, you know, it helped. That whole experience it just made it easier for me to, like, play the part, because I didn't have to act cold. It was there.
Yeah, and then you were in Slovenia with
Yeah, Slovenia with in the snow
minus 15, minus 20.
Yeah, with no pants. Yeah, so it was not fun, but no, it was fun as an actor. I mean, to get to experience things like that. I mean, it's hard, but it's, oh my gosh, this is what I live for. Yeah.
And I think it was great because the entire motel is built from scratch. Like you said, you guys only shot for like two and a half weeks, but they built the entire motel in just a month.
They did a great job.
Incredible. Everything from hand.
Yeah. And actually, just watching the film, everything is like, can you see it? It's cold. Yeah. Right? You feel cold. It's the color palette, even the visuals, very cold. So it kind of brings that sensation also.
Okay, we keep saying that it's a different cut from what was shown previously. What do you think is? How can you explain to the people like kung ano yung iba dito sa cut na ilalabas natin?
I think it's great because usually when you do a director's cut or something, or you do like a commercial cut, people kind of trim off minutes. But I actually added almost 5 minutes of footage into this film. A lot more creepy scenes, a lot more character moments. And the beauty of it is we also did another full sound design pass with our French sound designer. So I think it's really, really special because, I mean, not to say that we don't like working with people here, but we have the same relationship thing we want to do. Like we meet people in festivals, like our music composer we met in a festival in Australia. So our music composer is South African. So everything we hear in all the music scoring in the film is someone from South Africa doing it off-site. And then the sound designer is a great collaborator who's French, who's based in Cambodia right now. So everything, it's kind of like this. The film travels even in the post-production process to kind of get back to the Philippines again. So it's all new sound as well. It's fantastic. Black Sheep. It's really wonderful because they came in with the majority of the finance. I mean, this film's an international co-production, so the way we finance, the financing structure comes from a lot of parties internationally, from Taiwan, from Thailand, from Singapore, from Slovenia. But the majority, and I'm very happy to say, the majority of the financing structure comes from the Philippines themselves, ourselves. So Black Sheep, thank you very much for that part. And also, it's wonderful because the amount of creative freedom you Black Sheep gave me is—they didn't say no to anything. Oh, yeah, nice. The trust is great. Thank you.